Our coffee breaks with researchers aim to spread knowledge about regional development and innovation. By sending a camera around the world, we present you with different angles and insights on the topic. We ask researchers directly and in a personal manner about their work. We want to make scientific knowledge accessible to all.
Hi, welcome to Coffee Break with Researchers. Today, I'm having a coffee break with Markku Sotarauta. He's a professor at the Faculty of Management and Business at the University of Tampere in Finland. He's also an expert in regional development and leadership. Hello, Markku. Thank you for accepting my invitation to my coffee break. Today, I'm having a delicious black Colombian coffee. Which one are you having?
Oh, well, I'm having the traditional black bitter Finnish coffee imported from Colombia, I guess, also.
That sounds delicious, too. I was just reading one of your recent papers about how a cluster in regenerative medicine was developed in Finland. Could you please tell me what the paper was about?
The paper was about actors, organizations and people working for stem cell-based regenerative medicine that in time may turn into human spare parts industry here in Tampere, Finland. And we wanted to understand how it came about here, because they are doing revolutionary things, first in the world kind of inventions.
I find this topic truly fascinating. Could you please tell me which ones were your main findings?
First of all, our main finding was that it's a long journey. That's not surprising, lasting more than 20 years. The second observation was that there were kind of four main phases. The first one being planting the seeds of change. The second phase was about the collective belief formation. And in the third phase, they were making the decisions, establishing institutes and that kind of things. And fourth one, then really institutionalized the new form of science and prospective industry here in Tampere.
I see that one of the key concepts in your research is institutional entrepreneurship. Could you please define it for me?
Yeah, well, first of all, institutions are all those things that are framing our actions and choices. Normative things, regulative, cognitive, cultural, referring to our thinking. And institutional entrepreneurs are actors, individuals, groups of individuals, organizations or groups of organizations, seeing the opportunities to change institutions, and then they are taking risks in doing so. And that's highly interesting because there is no monetary rewards usually, but they sometimes end up having lot of difficulties too.
And I would like to know, which one was your main motivation in doing this research?
There was a dual motivation. First of all, I was the member of the board of directors at Institute of Regenerative Medicine at our university, let's say, I can't remember exactly, but 20 years ago. And I was really fascinated what they were doing and how they were doing and the whole setup. And then I wanted to understand how it came about here in this place, so that we perhaps could learn from it to help others do something similar. And the second motivation was that I was keen on finding a new way of studying agencies so that we could focus on really significant form of agencies, something really happening, something that is changing the institutions, not only very minute actions at micro level, but I was interested in finding a way to study the interaction between institutions and actors.
So what do you think we can learn from your research with regards to policy making and implementation?
First, I think the first lesson is that quite often we see policy in simplistic terms. The whole process started here outside the policy sphere almost completely. It was more like a scientific hunt of two professors from two universities. But in the second phase, we labeled as belief formation. There, the local, regional level policy practitioners, Center of Expertise Program in Health Technology especially, were crucial in forming a collective belief. What can be done, what is not, what are the opportunities, what is there, and so forth. In the third and fourth phases, the policy was more traditional and basically providing local actions with funding from Europe, national level, regional, local, and there are, I would say, dozens of sources of funding for that specific journey to establish human spare part industry here in Finland.
This is indeed a very interesting case study. Thank you very much for having this nice chat with me. I wish you all the best for your future research and see you next time. Bye-bye.
Thank you. It was a pleasure.
Thank you for joining us. If you are interested in more details about this research, find here the link to the academic publication. See you next time. Bye-bye.